Welcome to Analytics with Nax. In this video, I'm going to discuss about what is .date that appears after any date column that you refer in a time intelligence function. I'm referring to this part. If you are still confused, let's show me one of the examples where this is the total MTD calculation. It calculates sum of quantity and sales is a table and sale date is a date column, and I am referring a date column. But why I need to press or having an option of choosing dot date, day, a month that appears, right? This is the question most of the beginners ask me in the comment session. So, and also those who are also having some experience, they also doesn't have a good knowledge on that, why it is appearing. They go with the flow. If answer comes, then they are going. So to know the answer, why it is appearing, and if we can avoid it, right? Let's go into Power BI and check it out, why it's appearing and whether it's avoidable or it is necessary to avoid. Let's check it out in this video. If you are new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Let's begin. First of all, before getting into avoidance or understanding about that, let's try to understand this model, how it looks like. It contains sales, product master and location. We are not going to bother anything about these two dimensions. Forget about it. We also have a dim date. I have not connected this sales table right now with a dim date. We will connect it later. Now I have only this sales table. What is the data present in this sales table? We have receipt number. This is Naga Garments data. Those who are following my channel, they are familiar with. It's a typical sales data, whether it's ordered online or offline, what are the products ordered, okay? And we will talk about two date columns. I mean, we have two date columns basically. We will consider only sales date for our demonstration. So we have a sale date and a due date. And also we have a product master, which also contain a name, category name, brand, and then product created date. Okay, just for example, I've created today's date. So now, as soon as you come and see here, these date columns are appearing differently. Like we know, like data type of each column defines different symbols. It is numerical column, so sigmoid symbol, which can be aggregatable. This is a text data type, so it is not aggregatable. And this is the date column, so this is a symbol. That is what we thought, since it's a date table. But you see here, there is a hierarchy behind that, right? So what is this? So basically, like whenever you import a table into Power BI, it will, if it contains any date column, okay, that will create a hierarchy for you. This hierarchy is nothing but it will create one date table, okay? So for each date column in your table, it will create one table. So this is one table, this is another table. Even for the product, it creates the another table. This is the first point you need to know. So what option it makes you to create here, right? So this is the option over here that is making you to create a date column. Data load auto date time. When I uncheck it, if you see here the definition of it, automatically creates hidden date table for each field in the model that has a date or date type, date time, data type. Okay, so that is the point. Basically, it creates one hidden table for each date or date time data type column. So once I uncheck it, what will happen? Okay, now you see the product created date is gone, the date time, the hierarchy is gone. Even for the due date and sale date, it is gone. Okay, there is no hidden table here. So this is what the first option I'm talking about. Okay, why I'm talking about this? I didn't talk about the actual issue. Let me check it again. I mean, I will enable it again and we will come to this later. Keep this in your mind about this option, data load auto date time. Okay, time intelligence. Let me enable it over here. I have enabled it again. A date hierarchy appeared again. Now let's try to create one simple calculation, that is MTD of sales quantity, and we will try to compare it. Okay, and now I'm focusing only on sales. I'm not bothering about dim date, location, or product. So let me have total MTD, sum of sales quantity. Let me rewrite it again. Sales date, okay, bracket. Now it start appearing. Now you can see sales is a table, sale date is a column. When I complete it, the column name, it appears dot date dot month because it created one table. Now the sale date is a table, and then inside that hidden table you have all these columns, but this total MTD requires one date column, right? It requires some date field. That is what you are choosing dot date, because as we mentioned in the previous the checkbox, each date column creates one hidden table. So you are referring a column in the hidden table here. So once you refer it, just press enter. So this is the MTD and you are referring the hidden table. Now I want to analyze this data. Let us try to have this hierarchy here, and here to avoid confusion, I'll filter only for 2016. I will have only for 2016. And now what I want to analyze for each day MTD, that is for I mean here I have generated, it should be here. I will drag and drop a quantity here. So for each day, this is my quantity, and I have created this MTD figure. I will use this one now. Now what happened? You can see the MTD is working perfectly, all right, right? Sales quantity MTD 6, 12, 18, which is sum of these till the month end. That is January 31st. It is summed up. And from the beginning of February, again it is going. This is the behavior of MTD. Everything is working fine. But what happens when I not using this hierarchy? In the MTD function, right here, I've used the hidden hierarchy, and even here, I've used the hidden hierarchy. Now I'm removing this, okay? Instead of hierarchy, I will use, right? Okay, maybe I can use this one. I use only sale date. What happened now? Now you see the sale quantity MTD is gone because it is not able to calculate. Now I'm not referring the hierarchy or the hidden table. Now I'm referring only the sale date column, right? So this is the main difference. When you use a hierarchy measure, the hidden table, in your analysis also you need to use the hierarchy here. That is the key point. Now I am using the date hierarchy, which is using the hidden table. Now MTD will work. So either what how you use it, if you do not use the hierarchy, you use only the sale date, then go to your MTD measure, then remove this hidden table reference. Once you do that, you can see the MTD is working fine because now your MTD is referring a sale date column only. It is not referring the hidden table. So here also you are referring the actual column, not the hidden table. So your MTD is working fine. So this is the core logic behind the dot date, whether you are using the hidden table or the actual column. If you are using the actual column in your calculation, you also use the actual column here. If you are using hidden table, then use the hidden table. Now coming to the another concept of linking the dim date table. Now let me link this to the sale date. Now as soon as I link it, what happened? Now I will do here, you can see the sale date, right? The sale date is no more a date field here because it is connected to the dim date, and this is having a hierarchy. Now the same concept appears here. As soon as you put the value over here, let me use year over here for filter. Don't want to confuse why it's appearing blank and all. That is other part of the story. Now coming to our actual discussion, here I use the hierarchy. Okay, now when I use date, even this is not working because I'm not using the calculation for the date field. Okay, when you use the date hierarchy here, you need to change the calculation to use the date field, dim date dot date. Okay, what you are trying to use here, I'm using date, so I will use the date again here. Now calculation is working fine, right? 6/12/18/26. When I use dot date here, okay, in dim date, as soon as I press bracket, the hidden table enabled, and I get dot date. Hold on. Okay, see, this hidden table will appear only when you choose this one. Okay, just like that, once you complete it. Now again it will not work because here you referred hierarchy again, and you choose immediately date hierarchy, the MTD start working. The same concept applied for dim date. Once you create a relationship between dim date and sales date, you should not use the sales date. It should be hidden, hide for the client view. You start referring only the dim date. Whatever we have seen for sale date, if you use in your calculation the hidden hierarchy, then use the hidden hierarchy in your analysis. If you use the direct date table, you can use. This will not be the case in case you set this one as the date table. Now what happens, dim date dot date, still you are not set the this particular table as the date table. So once you set as a date table, you no more have a hidden table concept for the dim date. Okay, so once you have this mark date table, it will ask for which table as the date column. You choose date column here, this table, this column, then click on OK. Then you can see this becomes a date column. There is no more hierarchy concept anymore once you set the date table. So you remove this one, so it will be considered as date always. Now your calculation work. So this is the flow or concept behind your dot date. Basically dot date will appear once you have at auto date time set. That is the first point. And once you have a flat table, only you have a sales table, there is no date dimension, then either you use a hidden table in your calculation, then same hidden table should be used here, or if you refer only the column should be used. This is the point. The once you use the date table, the story is slightly different. The same concept applied if you are not applying as mark as date table. If you apply mark as date table, you always go for date, and only other columns you need to use, the year, other columns. This is the concept behind it. And I can say this is the correct solution. Like you set the dim date as the date table, then use the date value in your calculations, and again whatever you see along with your date, other dates, you should be disabled using auto date time. So this option should be disabled. So whatever you see in my channel, it was early videos that makes you to understand the Power BI. And in order to get the optimal results or performance efficient results, you need to disable this option. So all your date time will be disabled, because that will occupy a huge space. You should uncheck that option if it is a large model. So uncheck it. Then for all your date calculation, you need to use this dim date. I hope it was very clear about why the dot date is appeared and how to disable it and what calculations you need to use. You need to use always from the dim date date column. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries, and do remember that data is your asset.